All right, welcome to the most random podcast video interview thing in the world. I've got the biggest collection of random guests, and some you may know. And as you can see by the title of the show, we don't know what on earth to call it. It's a brand new concept. We don't know what to do as musicians anymore. We don't know what to do as people and as a society and all sorts of things. But we've got the interwebs and the power of you people. So, without any further ado, my first guest tonight, who am I going to randomly select? Oh, no ways. Could it possibly be Arno Carstens? Let's check out. Let's maybe unmute you. Wait. Uh-huh. There we go. Hello. Okay, hold on.
Hi.
Let's maybe get you in here as well. There we go.
Hello.
Are you echoing? Are you echoing?
No. This is when I talk.
Oh, nee, man. Let's get these comments up so we can see if we do have any comments. We've got some people online. Hey, we've got 40 people already. Okay, that's Kev. So we're busy testing out. We are. Oh, Arnie, what are you smoking? Are you smoking the devil's lettuce? Why not? You should.
Yeah.
We're allowed to do whatever we want because this is 2021, I think, as far as I know. Yeah. Hello, Beverly Stewart Webster. Oh no, are you
Buck Rogers?
Are you getting these comments? I want to just know. There's a setting that you should be seeing this somewhere on your screen. Okay, well that's not good.
I don't see anything.
I can't do anything about your eyesight, brother. Okay, let's check here. Okay, give me 1 second. So we don't know what to call this. We're just two oaks talking. Because that's all we need to do right now. I think everyone's feeling a little bit lonely. Guest web interface displays comments and view account. You should see that. I'm going to click it and unclick it. Okay, if it doesn't work, unlucky. You're just going to have to trust me. I'm going to have to read the comments out. But Arno...
Well, you can read.
I can. People are saying hello. Bev Stewart Webster.
Hi, everybody.
Ray Hendy saying hello. Lauren Leanne. So I just thought, hey, I want to catch up with you. I haven't seen you. We were meant to do a big tour, and before we knew it, another lockdown began.
Yes, so that was our December January tour gone, which is interesting.
Yeah.
Wonderful. Yeah. I've lost all the calluses on my fingers. Almost.
I know. It's getting very soft now. Yeah. I mean, I literally.
Yeah.
There's Constant. Why can't I? There we go. Add to the broadcast. Usad Balas. Okay. Well, that's kind of. I guess that's.
Hey, Usad Balas.
That's kind of the conversation. Can you see his name? Did that
now
come
I
up?
Can see
okay,
it,
brilliant.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, that's good to know. And then, you know, before we get all teleurgesteld, how's that lekker Afrikaans word for you? Because we're all in kak and we all were meant to do things, but I just thought, first of all, I miss you, and we are able to be connected by the power of the internet. So in a complete random moment, I want to introduce you to my lockdown partner and friend. She was on the roof with us, and when I filmed my rooftop shows,
you found her in the sea. She was lying on the beach.
Exactly.
Her fins were still splashing in the water.
Exactly.
And this mermaid was going to die.
Well, here we go. Here's the mermaid. Hello, Aline. There, kijk hoe kijk ze van mij. Hello, Aline. Gaan het?
Hello.
So I'm just gonna add random people, and I think the idea is that if you guys desperately want to talk to us on this thing. Hello, Dane Marshall, you absolute legend. I promise you I'm going to do a video about that beautiful Shure microphone you bought me for Christmas. Thank you. So the idea is, I think we should just add people randomly. Speaking of random people, I want to introduce to you another legend who's been helping Arno and myself because we are so bad at sorting our own laundry out. And we have Mr.
Yeah, but he's like our hero, right? He's
our hero. He totally is. Where is he? There we go. Simon, hello, sir. How are you, brother?
Oh, well. How are you? Hey, guys.
So, Constant is clearly extremely goofed because he's saying, what a song. I mean, that's just when you know. <I don't
laughs> That's it. It's like art when you talk. It just sounds like a song.
And yes, Jolene going teleurgesteld. Not bad, eh? Thank you, Jolene. I appreciate it. Hello to everyone who's watching and tuning in. The name of the show speaks for itself. We don't have a clue what we're doing. But if you'd like to be involved, let me know. I would have to quickly go online. Sorry, this is all brand new. I'd have to go and see the thing so that I can Facebook you and I can share the link of how to do this. And then at some stage, one of us will become the weakest link.
That is a great idea.
Yeah. What if I click myself out? So we've been sound checking and trying to get stuff working.
3 seconds. Who's the president of America?
Oh. Oh, the new one.
Biden, guys.
I'm just trying to Biden some time. Okay, wait. Okay. So I'm checking comments on the Facebook stream. If you guys want to, whoever wants to be included, there's Mark Devitt. Look at this guy. Speak for yourself, sir. This is a legend skipper who's been getting me through my conversion for sailing. So thank you very much. I appreciate that, boss. You're a legend. And check out another. I mean, just this is all this legends now. Check Jono Monkeys. Hello, boy. I think we should have Jono in. I don't know if we could get more than this many. Simon,
Jono's sitting on the toilet, buddy.
Jono, drop me out, mate. I'm easy.
What you've just got here, Simon? You've got to share some pills with us. While I'm busy adding, people, why don't you...
Sea pills.
Okay, check it out. This. Look at what I get to do. I get to put myself out of the picture, I think. No. You guys just take it away for a second. I'm just going to invite... Jono, are you ready to join us, Jono? I'm not on WhatsApp. So, okay. Okay, I'm going to ask a question that's going to buy you and Simon some time, and then I'm going to actually shut up, if you could believe that. Arno.
What the fuck?
Okay, hold on. This is Kip. This is working. This is actually working. This is going to be Kip.
It reminds me of our first interview with Barney Simon.
Okay, Jono's asking to be brought in. Okay, Jono, be on. Go to a laptop and get some headphones and open this link I'm about to send you in Google Chrome.
Oh, you magically just bring him in?
I should. Why can't I do it? What is wrong with me? Yeah. I hope your email's still the same. Otherwise, this ain't happening, baby. Okay, hold on. Oh, no, but I don't have to do that. Oh my god. Okay. Guys, come on, carry the show. Come on, be vivacious, be beautiful.
Sounds like you're trying to figure out some technical shit the whole time.
I am.
I'm giving you space.
Guys, come on. I mean, I didn't just bring you on to be gorgeous. I mean, you guys have to...
Okay, listen, let me lead this conversation.
Thank you.
All right. So, I would like to know, Art, have
yes.
you been writing music in this now... this jolly time that we've just experienced since Christmas, when you and me were supposed to be on the road, have you been writing any music or singing or playing anywhere?
No, is the actual answer, because I've been so flustered. Not that that's an excuse, but I've done nothing.
But you've been busy with a boat, right?
Yeah, but that I could only use that excuse for so long until it just ended up being, until it's actually just me being super lazy. So I eventually, Simon, this is one of Simon's jobs. He's the person who tells us that we're absolute idiots. And
but you see, I must say, the second lockdown kind of deflated me as an artist, though. I was like, oh,
yeah. Yeah.
You know what I mean? Not. It's just like, what now? I mean, it's just, it's kind of a wipeout. You know what I mean? Because obviously the first one was terrible. The second one was just unimaginable.
Yeah.
But I'm quite optimistic that in the next 3 weeks things are going to change. And I, you know, a lot of venues is closed down. So the Buddha's gone. I mean, and more is probably to follow. But what is cool is like I'm thinking of. I think this thing of just playing in people's gardens is at least it's a flipping venue.
Yeah.
But so I'm open to doing those venue. Shows, you know, taking the equipment and putting it on. If guy's got a nice big garden, he's got a whole bunch of friends, could do some awesome shows, man.
Well, Aline's got a. Oh, there we go. We got Jono Sherbert. Hold on, let's check this out. Give us a second. We can't get five in here, can we? I don't think so. this sounds like the minibus. The minibus that we had at the first Splashy Finn, Honor. Okay, let's check out. Four. Okay. One of you gonna have to go. I'm sorry, who am I gonna choose? Oh, this is so tough. This is awkward. Hold on. Jonna,
go for it.
Jonna, okay. Jonna, you're listening. I'm gonna ask you to call in exactly 2 minutes as soon as I finish the segment with Eileen, because I'm gonna keep it Simon on and myself after this. So Eileen, I just wanna ask you, how has it affected your business, which was all rentals, all Airbnb? Is it like,
well, currently it's affected me to the extreme the second time around. I think as most other rental companies, most of us have actually closed down. There's very little that we can do at this stage.
But
I do think that, you know, once these lockdowns start being lifted a little bit, we should be able to go back to some sort of normality. Hopefully soon. I think a lot of people are struggling, and I think it's been harder.
Can you handle a third one? A third lockdown?
I don't think so.
No.
You know, I mean, look, I would love to say yes. You know, look, realistically, we don't actually have a choice. So we would have to deal with it if it happens. But I don't think financially we'll be able to handle it.
I've heard is that next year, it's still South Africa, by next year things will get a little bit better with the antidote kind of starting to creep around, and then the year after that people will really start feeling their way out again, and then after that, so after 2 years, there'll be like this entertainment kind of renaissance happening with festivals and everything. That is if everything goes according to plan. But it's about 2 years, I think, that we are looking at.
It's a long time. No, I don't think it's going to change anytime soon. And I do see that there's a comment, you know, where someone actually says that it's not going to be going back to normality after this. And I'd actually agree. I don't think it's ever going to be normal the way as we knew it. There's going to be a lot of adapting.
Yeah, it's crazy. I mean, the scary notion to get used to is that this is going to be the new norm for a little while, which I know we've all spoken about a bit bored. So we will carry on talking. Darling, I want to thank you for, you sound checked from the word go. You've been on this for an hour already. So I've got Jono in the green room. Simon, you're a newcomer. Darling, love you. Good luck. I'll chat to you later. Everyone say goodbye. Eileen, thank you. Love you. Bye. Hold on. Let's see if I can get that right. Bye. Okay, and then remove from green room. Hey, check this out. Hold on. Who have we got here? Where are we? This is amazing. Johnny! Hello, love.
Hey. What's happening?
How are you, boy? Guys, where is your name? You must make a beautiful name. There we go. Let's make it a bit better. There we go. Use a capital letter for your name, boy. I mean, that's you know what I mean? Can we make this pro?
I went to one big boys, you know? Come on. What's happening?
Sure. Well, I mean, I just had a random idea that, first of all, it started with a missed honor because we were meant to tour in December and I haven't seen him since. We've been threatening to see each other. I've been talking to young Simon, for those of you who are just tuned in wondering what a random Englishman is doing in the bottom left of your screen. Simon's been
helping you set this up.
Exactly. He's been a champion. He's been involved in been one of the biggest fans of South African music that I know of, and he's very kindly offered to put his resources and his intelligence, of which obviously Arno and I don't lack any. And he's added to the team. Simon, on that note, I'm gonna love and leave you because I want to focus on Jono for a second, because he was one of the first people to capitalize on this. I will see you tomorrow at 11 o'clock. Bring your extensive Excel spreadsheet and all of my list of to-dos and all the things I've done wrong my whole career, and let's try and condense it into a 13-week meeting. That'll be great.
Into a paycheck.
Three things. Okay, three things. We chip off every Friday. Simon, you're a legend. Thank you so much, matey.
Cheers, matey.
Chat to you soon. Cheers, boy.
Cheers, Simon.
Okay, shit. I'm getting the hang of this. Okay, Jono, you were one of the original adapters, and you went straight in there with Jeff Fitness, which, by the way, is the name of my dog. So I understand that's where you were inspired. I mean, I understand he's an inspirational oak. I know where the abbreviation was.
We put the team together, and I thought about we have to name it after Jeff. I mean, like, Jeff is Gutty. I mean, come on.
Makes sense. It makes complete sense.
Exactly.
So yeah, bro. So we got a big event coming up on the 30th, right, of January. You're doing this.
Next weekend, whereby I'm going to be training for 25 hours continuously, with a 4-minute break in between. Every hour, and basically we're going to be raising a whole lot of money for Gift for the Givers to help all the obviously the medical personnel on the front line and stuff like that, and just have an incredible activation where we're going to merge exercise and music and personalities and just bring it to them. Because I mean, I know it's been a troubling time for you guys in the music industry with regards to, you know, not being able to do concerts, but there's definitely something in fitness and music. We tested it out with Goldfish, with Dom and Dave. It's working well, and I think this is the next step, and I'm excited to see how it works, man. It's going to be quite cool. We're going to be streaming an art from his boat, which is good, and I'm proud to announce too, Art, we're gonna take you up on a charter, and we're gonna be giving that away as a prize as well.
Sweet.
So we're gonna take it, we'll give it to one of our members, etc. And maybe we can twist Arno's arm to join us for one song. We can stream him in and give us a song. I'm on Ross as well. Ross and Denim are in. So we've got a commitment from Arno. Amazing.
Yeah, look at that.
Wow, what's going on?
So that's actually the reason of this whole phone call. Oh no, you didn't realize.
When is it? Just by the way,
it's on the 30th. And what we're doing, it, we've actually done it in associations with big concerts. The guys down big concerts, I've seen them, got in touch with us, and they said, "Listen, you guys are doing something special." I mean, how did you grow a community of over 70,000 people in over 110 different countries? And it's just, you know, it's just through connection and happy going. I mean, like, Art knows my wife very well, Julie. She's absolutely crazy, and she's a lot of fun, and our kids going nuts in the background, and it's just so real. And it's an awesome opportunity for us to give back and raise a lot of money and have a lot of fun and have a real, like,
you know what? I'm actually aware of this thing. I'm actually aware of this thing. Art, are you going to do exercises?
I'm cycling for half an hour on the bow of the boat, and you joining me. Okay. Except you're going to be running with a camera. You doing your 10 camera, because you're a famous runner, Arno. I mean, have you been running a lot during lockdown, apart from your demons?
I do my little 5Ks 3 times a week.
Well, there we go, Jono. Can we slide in a little 5K?
You can come. We're going to be broadcasting out of Adidas's head office. They got an amazing amphitheater there. We're going to have a stage, massive screen up. If you want to come and run the treadmill with me, come and do so. I mean, there's going to be a lot of personalities that are coming in. There's Dan Green is also going to be playing art. Danny's going to be doing a little thing, and we're going to be broadcasting in Goldfish for the evening session from the States, and a few other surprises. So if you're willing to donate a little song to us, that'll be amazing. Art knows exactly what you, by the way, you are cycling, but you are going to bring your guitar and play the song.
No.
Come on, man.
I've turned my guitar into a stationary motorbike. Of course, I've got a guitar on board. Are you joking? Of course I'll be doing that.
Amazing. So that's going to be
all right. Let's check that out.
Okay, awesome. But I'll connect with you.
It's not like I'm like busy or anything.
So. Oh God, it's so nuts, Jono. Listen, I want to just say well done for being one of the first to activate on that initial lockdown. Arno and I have been left trailing because we now have our fingers in our bums for the second one, and you started a riot. But I will say that, and I'll keep you online while I say this. I must say, Arno, everyone's been watching. We're watching your artwork. It's looking as much as the fitness and the boat look like we're showboating. There's something brewing over there. Have you asked Mel to go and pick you up a couple of your most recent works so you can display for us in a second?
Yes, that's a great idea, Melanie.
Well done, Mel. I can't believe.
So you can come show it here. So that's a great idea.
And so, yeah, exactly. I won't say it now, but I mean, there's a chance we could auction off a little work as well. Who knows? I mean, who knows? The same as when I say we're auctioning off a charter on the boat. It's actually just people doing a rowing session, because it's just an extreme row workout on when you come to Tim.
So that is clever. That is very clever.
Oh, guys.
I've got to jump out. My kids are going nuts in the background. So I just wanted to say thanks for bringing me on, and thanks for your commitment and your time for next week. It's going to be epic. We're going to raise a lot of money for these people and make a huge difference. Otto, I'm roping in for a song, big man. We're going to do this. It's going to be awesome.
All right, we'll do it.
That was a tough conversation.
And, I'll reciprocate with easy a like massive that. Case of amazing red wine.
Now you're talking. Jono, lots of love, there boy. Good luck, brother.
Thanks, guys. Awesome. Have an awesome evening.
Cheers, Jono.
Cheers, bro.
Cheers, guys. Bye.
All right. Well, now it's just you and I. It's everything that you dreaded, Arno. You didn't want to be alone because you were scared of what we were going to say about each other and to each other. But here we are. Just for people, you are welcome to, if you just want to say that you want to be involved, I'm going to invite you to this phone call, just randomly, to the session. It's got to happen pretty soon. So give me an indication that you'd like to be called in, and I will Facebook you a link. I think that's the only way that I'll DM you the link to this chat, and we can have a quick random conversation. We don't know, as I say, we don't even know what to call this show, never mind who we want.
Want to know, do you feel you're going to write some stuff soon?
I've been working on a little something. I don't know if, does this get rid of, oh goodness me. Hold on, let me just check.
Let me see. You could probably play some of your demos from these.
I probably can. Oh goodness, there we go, we've lost the whole show. There we go. Okay, so that shows kind of what I'm working on at the moment. So there is, I got a Logic session open. I am doing some stuff. I have to do,
who's playing?
Okay, hold on, I have to do this. This is live drums that are recorded today. I'll show you the studio, but anyway, it doesn't matter. It's literally two bars. So it's just, I think the song is going to be about someone who has been by your side during this lockdown, and it's called "Do You Make It All Right." So that's what I'm busy working on when I locked my phone away on whenever it was. I can't remember.
It sounds like a bit of a sleazy stoner love jam. I love it. It's cool.
Thank you, bro. Yeah, cool, man. So, thank you, Captain. Oh, no, you're echoing. Hold on. Sorry. Okay. All right. Okay, cool. Well, so no one wants to talk to us. We're not going to take it personally, Arno, because that's okay. I do just want to quickly go back. I'm not just saying that because we're bros and because we're on a call together, but I'm a genuine fan of the art that you've been doing. And that's something that's up and coming. When can I ask you, when did that, like the stuff you've been doing lately, like including the two ladies drinking tea that I'm, have you sold that yet?
No, it's yours.
Thank you, God. Okay,
I'm just
good.
Keeping it for you.
Please keep it. Just put sold on there and then send me the bank details and we'll put it in that folder of of things that we can't pay this year.
Exactly. I love it. Just put it in that one.
I'm going to put
my
it in
my favorite folder.
That folder is so full. So when did you start doing like so that was yeah. That was it. I see you've escalated a lot now, which is brilliant, but like when would you say from around that time that the two ladies with tea?
Shocks, man. When we started living in Cork Bay, and I think that was after London, then I really started painting a bit. But I must say, 2 years ago, it's almost been 2 years now. I've hanged out with some interesting people. That is, you know, it's again, it's like music. So is art as well. When you begin, you're kind of ignorant and you're so crappy, but you don't know it. But then you just keep going and going, and eventually you kind of get there. So, but I can totally see it. It's very visual. Where music, it's audible.
Yeah. You know, no, totally.
I can totally see it. So it's kind of interesting. It's weird. I mean, painting is a hobby, but you still got to really give it a go. Concentrate, you know, because you're kind of working. You're working against yourself the whole time, you know. Yeah. Same as with music. You just kind of want to better yourself from what you've done last time.
Yeah. How do you?
I think getting there.
How do you know when to literally draw the line? How do you know when something's finished? Because I'll share with you my experience, even though I still love it. It's still my favorite piece of yours. But on the day of that delivery, when I was coming to pick it up, you were still like faffing around as a typical artist, and you were hoing. And I was like, dude, I'm in love with what I saw. I'm not in love with what you, in your mind, are trying to...
The handkerchief wasn't done.
No, but okay, you see, but that's my point. But like, I was completely in love with that piece already. Can't we go and find this piece, please, somewhere? I want to show people, man. It's such a... As long as they don't pretend to try and...
She's not here.
Oh, she's gone. Okay. Okay. Well, if you check out Arno's site, it must be on there, right? You've listed that.
Yeah.
What's the website called?
I can actually send you a pic and you can put it on.
Okay. Yeah. Well, just list the website now. What's it called?
Arnocarstensfineart.com.
There we go. Okay, so if you go on to that and search for two ladies drinking tea, it is sold, by the way. It's just the money hasn't arrived completely in time yet. But that's the work that I'm talking about. Like, so when I came to pick it up, I was like, dude, I love that. And you were still with a farf and a brush and going nuts. So that's...
You think things are finished and then, you know, you just want to work at it so long as possible. Because there's always something you want to tinker on. I'm just looking for that painting. I can see it here.
You are able to share your screen, but we haven't figured that out yet. We're not that advanced. Oh, have you got it on your phone?
Yeah.
Okay. Well done.
So
well
I'm scrolling done. Through it.
Well done.
and then I'm sort of busy in the studio with Robert Auld was at my house today, the whole afternoon. He's been doing a song. He's producing a song for me.
Okay, rad.
Because I want to put up my album. Here we go. Oh, you can't go in.
Okay, there. Just hold it up. There we go. Okay, hold it still. Look at that, guys. I mean, if that's not that, that's one of my first. Okay, angle it differently. We're getting some light. Come, you can see it on it. You're not that goofed yet. Come on. Okay, there we go. There we go. I mean, I think that is spectacular. It is sold, by the way, everyone. So don't get any ideas. But my point is it. And you've also upped it. How many pieces have you done literally since kind of the new lockdown? Have you upped the output, or is it just me?
Yes. I'm now comfortable with about 2 in a week. I can almost...
What?
A week and a half. But then there's always like bits to fiddle on. But yeah, it's come a long way. It's much more productive. But there's an interesting story. A friend of mine said... he was talking to this very rich artist somewhere in Europe, and this rich artist, his wife was putting a canvas on in front of him. He threw paint on it, and in 30 minutes there was a painting. So this other artist, South African artist, asked him, so that took you 30 minutes, so how much are you gonna ask, you're gonna sell it now for how much? And he said, 300,000 euros.
Yeah.
And he said, yeah, but that was 30 minutes. He said, no, it wasn't 30 minutes, it was 30 years.
Goodness. Oh, yeah. But 30 years to throw paint on a canvas. The egg's got bad ass out. What? She's there, but yeah.
You know, exactly. Choose a hobby, you'll get good at it.
Exactly. All right, we're going to try something. Catherine Perman has said that she's willing to join us. Okay, so randomly, Arno, we're about to invite Catherine Perman. Let me just see where you are on Messenger. Sorry, guys, this is very brand new for me, as you will notice. Might have to put a first name. You don't mind speaking to a friend of ours on him for a second. Here we go, Catherine Pierman.
Of course I love.
Okay, let's check it out. Here we go. Catherine, you should have a link, and you can dial in whenever you are ready. And anyone else who wants to talk, There we go. This is the website that you guys must check out. Anyone has any questions, or if you want to talk to us, hey Greg, for you, and great to see you.
Things are happening here.
Things are going on. I mean, look at us. There's two odd. What were we going to talk? What were we going to call the show? Two sobbing dudes, or something like that.
Right, between two towers.
Between two sobbing guys, is what the show is going to be called. Let's just get a fern. You must have a fern on your side of the screen.
You know what was interesting is that in my high school, it had a saying like, and we are the power, or you know, something like that.
Yeah.
My high school had a kreet in Afrikaans, and it was opwaarts steeds, which means uphill always.
Oh my God. Welcome to the music career, everybody. That's how it is. All right, Catherine has called in. Arno, are you ready to say hello? Let's see if I can figure this out. Man. Give me one second. This is... Yeah, and so there we go. Catherine, here we are. Hello, Catherine.
Hello,
hey,
Sam.
How are you?
Where are you calling from? Var vandaan?
From Joburg.
Joburg. How cool is the interwebs, that we can do this right now? Welcome.
Absolutely. Good. Thanks, you guys. Awesome, awesome.
Yeah, man.
So... Aunt, are you good? What's happening?
We're good. We're okay. Anna and I are dealing with anxiety levels that are biblical at this stage, I would say, and learning how to cope. And what about yourself? What do you do, Catherine? What is your field, and how have you been coping?
Cool. So I know both of you actually, but I work in communications. So I used to be a journalist back in the day, which is how I know both of you.
And I just saw you the other day.
You did.
Ah,
exactly.
Ah, the snot thickens.
Five.
So okay. Yeah, I work in communication and I run my own business. Been doing lots of health over lockdown. So, yeah, I think I've been asking a lot of people the same question lately, which is really, if lockdown version 1 and 2 hadn't happened, what would you not have done that you have done now because of lockdown? What wouldn't have happened to you?
You first, Anna.
Wait, what would not have happened?
What would you have done different? What would you have done differently?
What positive came out of this whole thing? Actually, a lot. Basically, what it did was it broke the wheel, that everlasting wheel of touring. And one of these everlasting wheels that I've been enjoying lately is being in the studio and creating new music. So that one I like, but the touring all the time and kind of the same venues, that becomes problematic, you know. If I could tour more of the rest of the world, that would be fantastic, you know what I'm saying, if it all makes sense. But so this lockdown has taught us how to do flip. We suddenly had to learn how to do all this kind of streaming shows. And you know, we had to learn a lot of things, so that is a positive.
Yes,
it's also taught us that, you know, you can actually survive without live music in a certain way, although you're probably not going to have any sense, you're probably going to lose your house. But it's...
Stop that. Don't, take that back.
You can actually...
You take that back right now.
You can in a certain way, because now we're concentrating on selling T-shirts or stuff like that, or art.
You've got T-shirts?
You know what? Yeah. You know... So that's me. So Art, what's your...
No, I agree. I completely agree with the same sentiment. I think what I would have done is, had I known that the second lockdown was going to be as intense as this, because I think for a second, I don't know, I obviously only speak for myself and it's always only my opinion. I think for a second we perhaps thought that that was about as bad as it was going to get. I don't think we had full grasp on the second wave yet, you know, and we thought, well, second wave is, you know, we're going to be better equipped and it's not going to be as hard a lockdown. So I think, I would have definitely taken the whole thing not, I mean, I've always taken it seriously, but I wouldn't have been so kind of blasé about the fact that what's about to come. I mean, I'll just share with you right now. This is the worst that position that I've been in for since I started doing music. I mean, to not have one gig in the calendar for all of 2021. The last show I did was kind of mid December. I mean, that for a musician, you know, that shows you how close to the edge we fly, which is also not too clever either. But that's how we live. That's the life we subscribe to, and you know, we're hustling. So I can only imagine, you know, people who aren't even as fortunate as I believe I am, that I know we all are, you know.
Yeah, absolutely. I remember our first gig, we got a six pack. You know, now I don't even get a six pack.
Yeah, especially now you don't even you don't drink anymore, so it's wasted.
Oh well, it's a thought. Flipper now.
Yes.
What's that, Catherine? You were going to say?
No, I was going to say, I think that, you know, what I've noticed from a whole bunch of my musician friends and you two included is that you're creative in many ways. Your music is one way, and I've been seeing so many beautiful things coming out of so many people that just, it's projects that would have sat on the back burner. It's
that's true.
Emotional stuff that they're sitting and dealing with, and I think that always makes you a stronger artist, right? I think it's just time and space. Quiet space to be creative is like the most powerful space, and I don't think you guys give yourselves enough time to ever be quiet. So
Very true.
I think that it's going to produce like a really rich, powerful movement in music, because it's been created and challenged and very mindful times. So I personally look to what's going to come out of this.
You know what? I was just saying about that, where they say this year's crappy, next year's going to be a bit better, and then the third year, this entertainment revolution almost. If everything goes according to plan, you know what I'm saying? And I can see, I'm quite optimistic. We have to be optimistic, you know? So.
Yeah,
but if we can hang in there, I mean, art's fine. He just goes, you know, he goes on the boat.
No, bro. No, that's another misconception that I need to clear up, because it looks
like a pirate.
No.
He eats seals from Robin Island.
Oh yeah. No, that I do. Yeah. That, but guilty as charged. But you know, it's all, you know, the bank owns certainly most of my life. Oh, no, I don't know about you. So everything that I do is not the typical.
They send me flowers.
It's not this.
They
not
send
the,
me flowers. They worried the, about me because I'm
It's not as glamorous and the rock star life that people might see, like yachts and castles and gigging and artwork and stuff.
No,
we are hustling. The bank owns most of it. It could be taken away in a heartbeat. So just to let people know, Catherine, who is walking into your frame in the middle of this wonderful interview? For goodness, share their names.
My very tall son.
Hello, very cool son. How are you? Reveal yourself immediately. Say hello to us.
This is also David Owens' son, by the way.
My dear Lord.
Kan jy dit nou glo?
Wat raar. Kom kom sien sy face. Ek moet kyk of ek sy pa ons oop kan sien.
Say hi. Quickly, just pop your head in the frame.
Show your face,
please. There we go. Hello, son.
How
your
are
hair,
you?
Your hair is fine. Okay, I'm also going to do what you just did right now. Is that better? You guys prefer the middle path or the side path?
How old are you?
15.
Listen, from here on, it's just uphill, but like cool.
It's like that. It's like that. That school. Like really, what does that school motto again? Say that again.
Upward steeds.
It's just always uphill. Nice to meet you, buddy. We'll see you soon, bro.
Disappeared.
Oh,
he's
goodness.
A
Listen, Catherine, thank you so much for your time. Thanks for calling in. I want to tell
awesome.
Other people.
Thank you.
we got a few more minutes left. Who knows? We don't know the rules. Arno's probably late for dinner, but we've probably got a few more minutes. There are no rules. So if you want to be part of this, we could probably take one or maybe even two other guest callers to be with us. But Kat, thanks for being our first. You're our first call-in guest ever. You're a legend.
Thanks
for the support. So that was pretty cool. Let's see who else.
You check she's a journalist, though, because she asks like really intelligent, cool questions.
Exactly. Hello, Jilzy. There's Jilzy Mikey. Hello, hello, hello. Who else is going to... That's Jono's wife. Julie Mikey's also... How are you getting these videos done that you do on Jeff? You do all the... You do the quick changes and then you all of a sudden in some Adidas gear, obviously, must be, but you must tell me the software you guys use. Please, Jules, I need to know. Okay, let's check what else we got here. Arno, go, shoot. It's your turn for a question. Hit it while I sort this out.
All right. So, a question.
Yes.
The following question shall be...
Oh, my God. Okay.
About what is the vibes around any Just Ginger shows? Or album, future of that. How do you see it playing out?
I'm not too sure at this stage. Like I in my brain can't even fathom traveling at the moment. So because the boys live in Joburg, it's always been hard. And now we're in a pandemic.
No, but say you take out the whole COVID and the whole thing. You know, now that we've been for so many years, we've been like these, you know, in Just Ginger, Springbok Noodles is these bands that's almost like family, you know what I mean?
Yeah. No, listen, of course.
So many years, but in this new world kind of, I'm talking about ignoring the COVID thing.
Yeah.
It's just interesting. I mean, I've seen how bands age and some of them get it right really well. And then others kind of just...
It's different for everyone, I think. And I think my answer to that is that I think it's silly to ever call something quits, like unnecessarily. Like, I don't think we need to say that. The thing, we don't have any plans at the moment. But you know, we're still on this earth together. We've been through so much. You know, we also have ups and downs about miscommunications and all sorts of things, and so we also go through our own cycles. But I would say the answer to that is never say never with that. And speaking of which, you guys had an album that came out end of last year, didn't you?
No, man, we were supposed to.
Did you not do it?
It's our album. I think I'm going to call it the Chinese Democracy 2. Because it's like taking it that it's recorded 2 years ago. It's taken so long to get out. So me and Theo are supposed to be in the studio now, mixing it down and finishing it off.
Yeah.
But Theo's got the vert at the moment, but he's very cool. I think he's in fine conditions.
Oh goodness! Okay, I didn't know that. I'll hit him up. If anyone wants to join us, we're going to be on here for probably another 15 minutes. If you can spare, please, Arno. And basically, we don't know what to call the show. It's just...
I think it's a very, very awesome show.
Yeah. I think so too. Let's do it again. Let's, you know, because at the end of the day, like, I think something that I've realized is that people are more lonely than ever before. And, you know, we're all going through this thing. And what I see all the time is people thinking that it's just them. But we are all, excuse the French, we are all fucked. That is what it's been. I apologize.
You know what? Maybe you should call it Smoker's Corner, because people can actually smoke in this bar.
Exactly. We can smoke and drink whatever we have left in the privacy and comfort of our own homes. But if you guys have any suggestions, do tell us. Feel free to ask questions. Always good to hear from you guys. It's a little bit delayed on this software that I'm using. Do share it. One way that you can support artists, and this is not a plug for me, but Arno, have you activated your stars thing on your streams? Because I did that when I did my rooftop thing.
I'm not sure about that.
Okay, someone needs to...
I've heard about that, you know, my Melanie, my wife, is my brain and my everything, so I will ask.
Melly, we need to get you onto activating stars, and then every time Arno interviews someone or does a live show or a live jam, instead of having to have a QR code, which has worked, and it's cool, it will still work, we'll do it in the future, then you can also just, it's something that Facebook has created, and it's actually very effective. I got quite a few stars for that rooftop thing that I did, so it's a way to support musicians.
Okay, Art.
Yeah.
I've got a thing. I'm busy with my 80th playlist.
Okay.
80th playlist.
Yeah.
On spot. We like do a show, like DJs, and then we like play some stuff, play a song, and then we chat a bit.
Dude, we can do whatever we want. We are severely unemployed. So as long as Telkom doesn't cut our internet off, we can pretty much do whatever we want.
No, we've got to figure out how to play it then, the video and.
Okay, I'm on that
specific song, and that could be quite cool.
So on, so
and then
you,
also yeah. what to choose, what to watch on Netflix and stuff, because I'm lost.
Yes, I agree. Well, I can share.
We've got interesting topics that people can help us with.
I totally agree. I think we need Netflix. I mean, this is not going to be normal conversations. We're not going to be talking about music, because you know, as much as we've been fortunate in the past, our music is not all that. We are bigger than that, and most people will be bored of us talking about music in general, including ourselves to death. So we have to talk about life things now, real life situations, trials, tribulations, fears, anxiety, Netflix recommendations. Speaking of which, did you watch Queen's Gambit? Tell me you watched all of it and that I loved it. I mean, how
then
ridiculous.
I just want to give you a tip. If you love the Queen's Gambit, and sometimes I lie in bed and I read a bit of shit on my phone and I watch something on Netflix. Now, the thing that is perfect for that is The Crown. It's hours and hours of slow-moving history, beautifully portrayed in great style with some very posh English, and it's so interesting.
And is it actually?
Plus,
is it,
you can read other stuff while in the video.
So you can basically, what do people do? They're just on their phones while that's that shot of people just on their phones while watching Netflix. I mean, what a society have we become? I mean, I know this seems contradictory, but I've locked my phone away since what day is it today? Thursday. I think it's Thursday.
Okay.
So I locked my phone away since Tuesday night, and it only unlocks tomorrow. So I've got this weird contraption that's a blue box, and it's got a vault on it. You know about it. So I just I'm trying so hard not to be full of gadgets.
But why are you kicking against the bricks?
Say what?
Why are you kicking against?
Because I'm completely addicted to my phone. I literally live like this the whole time, waiting for a beep. And what kind of music do you think I'm going to be making? What kind of What kind of efforts towards doing something like this am I going to do while I'm scrolling through Instagram the whole day? It's a problem. I can tell you right now, it is a problem for me. So I have to go hard yards and lock it away. That said, I do still have an iPad, but okay, no, there is no social media on here. And the only way I'm able to do social media is on this on the main computer. Not that I'm justifying anything. I'm just telling you that's like my problem. Like, I'm properly addicted to my phone.
I really do see kind of Twitter and stuff like that, as it is great. It's taken over from the U magazine next to the toilet.
Yeah, exactly. But that's
it is such interesting reading, little material, little snippets.
Yeah.
You know, and especially if you follow stuff that you're interested in, like I love science or archaeology and stuff, and it's amazing stuff that comes out there.
But what would you say your average screen time is on your phone? Like, have you checked? Be honest, come on. This is the honesty pool.
It's been hours and hours.
Hours, dude. It's hours. Now imagine if you spent that writing a song with me, or writing a song for yourself and painting another stroke, and it said your shits take 10 times longer because you're going through your whole feed, so you're also messing your gut biome up.
But I am in a very good I'm in a very good rhythm. I wake up and first thing I'm either going to go write a song, and when I'm finished with it, I get bored and I paint a bit, then I write again.
Ah, you see.
I feel too guilty, man. So I'm good with it. It's just my guilt. I have to create something the whole time, otherwise it eats me up.
Well, that's amazing. Well done, bro. I think I wish I had that drive. So, and then another topic I want to talk to you about is you've been dope free for, you've been, have you still been, by the
two
way?
Years.
I 2 years, dude.
2 years. Yeah.
Okay, cool. And how's that working out for you? I mean, you must laugh when they do the lockdowns now. Yeah.
It doesn't bother me at all, but I mean, look, the big thing you lose is your social, that social world of getting totally trash, and you know, that kind of fun element of it is kind of gone, which is sad.
Yeah, but
then
is it?
Again, I've had enough of that, you know, and eventually I just became a bit embarrassing, so I embarrassed myself to sobriety.
Oh, dude, you were you are so loved. You know, people love you all the time, and it's amazing how hard we are on ourselves. But I guess, you know, the truth is, I mean, we've all had moments where we go, oh my God, that is not the person that we want to reveal. And we have to have that aha moment of going, what works for us or not. And I know Francois von Koch was one of the very early adopters going, and he just said, it doesn't work for me. And that makes a lot of sense.
Yeah.
And I think...
I must say, him and Albert Frost were... and Theo Kraus as well, years ago when they... And yeah, man, I've just seen people around me, of course, not, things not going well. Remember Heiser Burger from Batre Niefe?
Yes.
I just saw this thing playing out, and I'd rather concentrate on writing awesome music and, you know, not drinking myself into stupidity. I'd rather concentrate on that. But it was fun, and I definitely will not do a thing. I do not regret my past or whatever.
No, you shouldn't, and you got to move on. And also, I mean, I think weed works better for some people. Alcohol works better. We all do have a poison that either complements us or devastates us, and usually the devastating one is alcohol. So it's a good call. So I think, I don't know. What are you guys' opinions about this ridiculous ban? I think my opinion about everything, which is just my opinion, always disclaimer, and it usually comes from a highly uneducated position. It's ridiculous, but also how are restaurants supposed to, the restaurants are closing down because customers have to leave at 8. How do you, in Europe, you don't even think about dinner until 8 o'clock, then you go out and then you put your order in. I mean, I don't understand how we are not open until at least 11 or midnight, or why even the curfew. I mean, the alcohol is mental already, but yeah.
I mean, who's ever going to open up a restaurant again in the future?
No, absolutely. You know,
it's like such a risk. It's such a risk. And that means there's no more real... They're gone are the sort of the smaller theatres then in a certain way. Hopefully not totally everywhere. But I mean, so that's why I say I think the next big guerrilla warfare in entertaining people with music is going to be in their backyards.
Yeah, you're right. Well, dude, you've seen where I live and you've seen my roof. So I think the next thing needs to be, but I've told you before, it's always weather dependent. So we are going to, that is going to happen. I'm going to call you one day and you must just be ready, Arno. You'll probably be available, hopefully, as will I. But listen, I've got a cool surprise, Arno, if you'll hang in there. I've got a mate of mine. I don't know if he's still in LA. His name is Charles Butler, Gilbert Charles, and he was one of our big chums. Well, still is, but I haven't seen this dude for. Okay, I'm talking crap. Let me just get him in here. Let me get him. Hold on. What is up, baby? Hold on. Wait. There.
What up?
How you, brother?
I'm living life, struggling in these times.
Dude, meets Arno. I don't know. You remember us talking about another band in South Africa called Springboard New Girls? This is the lead singer, in case you haven't put two and two together. But
That's what I thought.
Yeah, dude. So there's Arno. Where are you, Charlie boy? Where are you?
I'm still in LA in Torrance.
Okay,
down
cool.
By the beach.
Okay, and how is LA these days? I've heard interesting stories.
It's probably all true.
If you were involved, for sure.
No. I've never quarantined myself this much, not just because of the virus, but because of people are acting up these days. And just, like, I posted a video last year about somebody calling me the N-word driving down the street.
What, in LA still? I mean, really, I mean...
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Dude. Crazy stuff, dude, I mean, it's just crazy.
That's why I said the world needs you guys. The world needs you guys.
Oh, thanks, mate. The truth is, during lockdown, we actually need each other, bro.
Need them.
How are you feeling? I know we're not allowed to talk politics. We won't. But how are you feeling about yesterday? Are we stoked? Oh, Charles is gone. We lost Charles. That was a beautiful word. Very, very cool. All right, he's ducked. That's very, very cool, man. Charles, thanks.
That was a quite interesting a little glimpse into the American.
Yeah, world, into right? into the American mindset. I must say, like, I'm a big fan of Joe Rogan. I don't know who else is. But you know, he's moved. He's left LA. He's living in Texas. Yes, Charles. I think he accidentally hung up. Let's get him two more seconds, right?
But tell me, Art.
Yeah.
What is happening in LA? Why is it? What's?
Oh, sorry,
what Charles. You press the wrong. You press the wrong button, baby.
Yeah, I did.
So tell us. It's where you can't touch your toes anymore, baby.
That's what happens when you get old.
That's obviously an inside joke that we're not going to tell any of our viewers about. So the question, Charles, was... the question was... Dude, okay, no, concentrate. Charles, concentrate.
I still can't believe you heard me.
Okay, Charles, stay with me. Stay with me. Moving on. Tell us about Los Angeles. What is happening? Apart from the crazy racism that still exists. Okay, can I ask you quickly, how do you feel about yesterday with an inauguration? Yes, yay or nay? We're not gonna divulge because opinions differ.
Okay.
Quickly though, we're not gonna indulge this.
Okay, no, but to understand this, first of all, I definitely don't believe that this is the United States of America. We're not united. Yeah. Honestly, these are 50 different countries under one umbrella. You go from one state to another state, they have different laws and different regulations.
Yeah.
And so I still, like, you know, I grew up in the South, like the dirty South.
Yeah, yeah.
With a lot of, it's a very blue state, not blue state, a red state. And I still have friends that I went to high school with that are animate about wanting Trump back in. Right. And I'm not that person to kick people off just for their political views. I'm not that person. Actually, I like listening to them because I know where this country is starting to head.
Yeah, exactly. If anything,
unfortunately,
yeah.
a lot of people in this country don't like change. From the Midwest to the South, they don't like change. Yeah. Only big cities like change.
Yeah. So yeah, shit, dude. It's a hell of a complicated thing, Charlie.
But you know what's the weird thing? I check on CNN, man, and you know, like, these people patrol. The
Charles, just turn your turn your computer down a few clicks. Sorry, mate. Sorry, Arno.
Okay.
Just turn it down, just the volume, because it's feeding back. Okay, go, Arno, hit it.
You know, just like a lot, like Americans have got guns, everyone, you know, like machine guns and stuff, and it's crazy, you know, like other. Walk around there in these little troops of machine guns, and I mean, fuck, that would be scary for any government.
Yeah, bro.
You have citizens, you know, with different pockets of beliefs walking around with machine guns. It's scary.
Charlie, sorry, brother. We're not gonna get into politics because it's so diverse, it's so hectic. But I feel for you, and it's so good to see you, my brother. The love remains. The love is real, and hang in there.
Good luck.
Hang in there, my boy. I'm gonna slide into them DMs after this chat. But it's so good to have you, bro.
Lovely to meet you.
I think you muted yourself accidentally.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Cool, my boy. Lots of love, Charlie.
Man, like I said, my one thing I want to do in life, and I almost had a chance to do it on the Mariah Carey show, was go to South Africa just to be around you guys just one more time in your homeland.
Oh, dude. Well,
because
cool, man.
Those nights of staying up, talking and just conversing back and forth and being human beings, that meant a lot to me.
Dude,
even to this day, it's still
very special. I can't believe that it's over 10 years ago, bro, and you are missed. And
yeah.
I hope to see you. I'm gonna get D on the line at some stage. We'll have a little catch up as well, bro.
Yeah,
boy.
Okay,
Charlesy, lots of love, my boy. Take care, bro.
Bye.
Cheers, dude.
Cheers.
Bro, so just to give you guys some backstory to that as well, Charles was one of our good mates in, when we lived in LA, and shoof, the amount of nights we just spoke about life and all sorts of things, and that was just so cool to see his face again. It's the same happy countenance that I remember from back in the day. That was a very cool surprise. This seems to be working quite fun. What do you think? I know, just random Oaks calling in that we didn't plan.
Man, I love this. You know, that was such an interesting call. I really like Charles.
No, Charles is a legend. You will get to South Africa one day. It might not be with Mariah Carey. It might have to be with just Ginger and the new girls. But we will get you here, brother. Don't you worry yourself.
Candice wants to know what I'm smoking. I'm smoking a box of tobacco.
A box of tobacco? Why? What? Are you rolling your own? Are you doing your own rollies now?
Yeah.
Shit. Yeah. Okay. Well, I mean, but why? We don't have to hide anything. But why aren't you smoking weed? We've got nothing to hide. I mean, are you joking? Everyone smokes weed, and everyone should. What's Mel saying What's Mel saying in the background? No, no. Oh, come on. Are you joking? What's gonna happen? Are we not gonna get any gigs? Okay, well, I should hope so. Are you joking? This is a free society. Weed is legal. There we go. Thank you very much. We are able to talk about.
It's all we can do.
It's what it is. Who cares? Are you joking? I mean, you see, we are so conditioned, you and I, Arno. That is such old school paranoia to be like, we can't talk about the dachas.
Dude, I'm living my dream. I'm staying at home. I'm writing music, recording it on GarageBand, doing paintings. But yeah, eventually I'm really looking forward to playing some live shows. But I must say, making some money, that would be great. But
what is this money thing?
A bonus.
What is this money thing you speak of? Never heard of it.
Wonderful.
Dude. Okay, well, no one else wants to join our conversation. I'm offended and devastated. But that said, I'm not letting you go anywhere. Yeah. Yeah. We're not finishing this.
I'm going to think about some things to talk about. But interesting. You know, there's some interesting things there in the world. Here's an interesting thing. You know, the cross is a symbol of Christianity. You know.
Yeah.
But it's a very ancient symbol. Very before it comes from, even before Christianity, and they reckon that it is the scientific symbol of the cross symbolizes human existence in a certain way, because it's where light and time crosses.
Right. Yeah, that makes sense.
And that's the cross, and that's where, you know.
Where is that? Where did you get that from? What is that symbolism?
This book I'm listening to about light. And I can't.
This book you're listening to, I love it. We are such modern people.
Listen, hang on, here it is. The Secret of Light by Walter Russell.
Okay. Hold it up. No, more middle, more. There we go. Check it. Walter Russell, The Secret of Light. Unabridged audiobook. A fantastic read. Donovan Seagreen. Okay, this could be interesting. He's going to join us. I'm going to send you an invite.
Someone's joining us.
Donovan, are you stoned? Who knows? I don't know. I don't know what we're on about. We're not promoting anything. I think what we are promoting is that everyone has their free will and free choice to do what they need to do. I seriously believe that. I'm not even kidding. That is... Okay, there we go. Donovan, here we go. Here's your link to join the conversation. And we'll hopefully see you just now if you're not too goofed. Just remember, it's the green button if you want to...
You go, boy, Donovan.
Come on, Johnny. There we go. We have someone watching from someone watching from Korea. Check this out. Hello, Cass. Thank you for joining us. How rad, man. Okay. Candace, whatever you started. Exactly.
And Flip. So Black Crowes. Remember the band? Black
yes.
Crowes.
Yeah.
Hey,
yeah.
A little bit when you
hear. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
They brought out a new song.
Yeah.
Interesting. And then Foo Fighters has got this new song out that was influenced by Motorhead, which is quite cool.
Is it quite heavy?
Yeah, it's got like a bit of a Motorhead vibe to it, but it's a good. I'm just so glad they're bringing out some good stuff, you know.
Cool. Yeah. Okay. Well, here's Don. I'm gonna put him in the waiting room for a second. Don, if you can hear our voices, please put headphones on. If you do have headphones, otherwise, make sure that your computer audio is super turned down. And geez, just from what I can see in the green room, I can see super red eyes. But I guess that's the point. Let's okay. Sort yourself out. You're a bit wobbly. Get your headphones in there. Sit down. Settle down. Get a beer. And I'm gonna let you in when the image stabilizes. You're looking fabulous, by the way. I love what you've done with the place. Arno, cool. Okay, so that's a good book, and Netflix, we've been through that. We mustn't bust through all of that. So, but because we need
I don't have anything on Netflix at the moment, though.
Yeah, me too. I must say, I caught up with Peaky Blinders right to the end. Finally, I watched the very beginning, loved it, and then didn't watch anything from season two, I guess. And now I'm like gobsmacked that they're not, that they haven't. When is the 20? It's supposed to come out 2021. We need season six.
They say season six is the last one, I think.
Yeah.
But it's fantastic. Peaky Blinders was just absolutely amazing. The music was fantastic, and
how good is the music? The styling, bro. Are you joking? Cool. They reminded me of you, bro.
Arthur's suits, man.
No, ridiculous, bro. With a chain and the thing in them. So thin.
And they really do look hungry. They look hungry. I mean, you can't put me in a suit like that. I'd look chubby.
Listen, No, bro, are you joking? Why do you think this interview is basically from here down? I can't even begin.
South Africans don't look that cool in suits like that.
No, definitely not. Okay, Don, are you looking? I'm gonna let you on for 2 seconds, but if that doesn't stabilize soon, it's gonna be a quick hello and goodbye. Everyone, welcome Donovan Seagreen. Okay, don't make sense. Good. Hold on 1 second.
Hey, Donnie, you're so fine. You blow my mind. Hey, Donovan.
Hey, Donnie.
How's it going, dude?
Hey, Donovan.
How's it, brother? Long time no see, dude.
What's up?
Do you know Don, Arno?
No.
Do I know you, Don?
We joined with Seagreen Blues.
Oh, shit. I'm sorry. Okay, cool. All right. How you doing? Where are you? Where are you based?
Still in Durban, man. Everything's locked down this side.
Hey, whereabouts in Durban? Whew, someone's got access to just about everything. Do you want to share a little virtual?
It's Durban.
Yeah, you're right.
There we go.
We're not like the rest of the country. We're kind of like even speed signs and stop signs and general stuff from the government is more like a recommended, but not enforced.
Exactly. Very cool.
And on the beach, is anybody on the beach there?
Actually, the guys are going out with fishing licenses on boats these days. They're kind of going through the limits. I think they caught that on from Cape Town.
I heard about Oaks doing the fishing license thing.
Is that for real, though?
Smart as hell. Yeah, man.
Yeah.
Okay, because I know...
They're quite sharp, yeah. I mean... Say again?
Go on.
Yeah, you said they're quite sharp, Donovan.
Yeah, I know. The guys, the loophole, this is loophole country.
Yeah, no, you know? Durban, I know.
Anything
bro.
With the loophole, well, dude, you know.
What am I? I'm trying to find the right tattoo here. There you go, boy.
Oh, my favorite tattoo.
I say. Chicken bicep. I mean, you're joking. I mean, what are you even kidding? Okay, Kazi, I'm gonna give you a question each, Donovan, because you're a legend. Thanks for joining us. Thanks for breaking the ice with us.
Shut up, brother.
Hit Arno and me one question each, and be nice. I think my mom's watching.
Ooh. Be nice.
Yes, I think my mom's watching. Come now.
Impossible.
I have faith in you.
When will you guys do a collab album together?
Oh, there's a,
let's do it.
There's a joint question.
Straight up,
bro. I'm in a studio. Why do you think we're doing this interview? I mean, like, I'm set up. I've got like I've got a keyboard and everything. It's like and electricity while I can until the council.
And the rooftop.
Well, that can't be a joint collab album, but we can do the show. I must say, I'm just putting it out there, but this Saturday the weather's looking pretty good. Oh no, I mean, I know you.
There we go.
You still got a car, don't you?
Who, me?
Yeah, what is it about?
I was inviting Arno to potentially come and do a rooftop show. Would you tune into something like that, Don?
Shit. This weekend.
Of course, man.
Yeah, maybe. Don't say this weekend like you got plans, Arno. Don't talk shit now.
Well, I wanted to go visit my elderly mother, but maybe that can wait. For a gig, it can wait.
Well, exactly. I mean, but well, okay. I'll let you know afterwards because we have to check weather out. Obviously, being a rooftop show, it's completely weather dependent. But Don, bro, thank you for doing this with us, brother. I'm glad you look like you're in good spirits, and thanks for the support and being a legend, my brother. Where are we getting this? One way, my boy. Shot, boss.
Later,
cheers, brother. Bye.
Yes.
Oh no! What a joel, bro. Are you kidding? What are you doing tomorrow night? Same time. Let's do this again.
I don't think I'm doing anything. I don't know what I'm doing.
If you're not coming to my house, that means you're doing the wrong thing.
Yeah. We should do an album as well.
I agree.
Got the time. I'll write five songs, you write five songs. I'll send it to you.
We can't do it in the flesh, eh?
We can, but it's so easy just to write on your just write five songs and I write five songs. And then we put it together. That's step number one.
Okay.
Step number two is...
Five songs. That is such a commitment, bro. I've written like two songs in 2 years.
Okay, but five little ideas.
Okay.
It doesn't have to be fully songs. Just like...
Okay, can we start with one idea? And then like I'll send you a verse or you send me a verse. What about that thing that you wrote at Scarborough, man? Did you ever record that?
Faces like this,
100%.
And I'll be waiting for you.
Faces like exactly. I remember that, bro.
Yes, so you see, when you sing it, it sounds amazing.
No, bro, but I think together Oaks will dig that. I think so. Tell us what you think on the feed. Give us some thumbs up if you think we should do a song together. Finally,
you should give it a Fleetwood Mac-ish vibe.
Bro, I wonder if I can show you.
Faces like this, they come and go.
100%.
Now I'll be waiting for you.
Wait, I'm gonna... I've got the drums right here. I mean, I'd record that now. If you send me... Do you still have that voice note on your phone?
I could do this from here now. I'll send you a voice note.
Okay. Well, the same one. Do you still have it? Play just a little tiny snippet to the good people.
Well, I don't know where that is. I don't know where that is.
But it should be on your phone. That's why that's what we have the cloud for.
No, but it's like 5 years ago.
Oh, come on, Arno.
Let me just record it and I'll send it to you.
Okay, no problem. I want to show people that I'm not lying.
Faces like these, they come and go, and I'll be waiting for you in spaces like these.
Okay, cool. Send that to me. I'm only gonna have my phone's only gonna be unlocked on Friday anyway, so I'll get it then.
Oh, I thought you just throw it in, you put the drums behind it.
Well, like what now?
There we go.
Jeez, bro, that is hectic.
Remix.
Pressure.
Yes, yeah, you're like a genie on the drums with those things, man.
No, bro. No, but I love that. I mean, I should be equipped enough to be able to run on and go and. Where did you send that to my voice note?
Yes.
If you email that to me,
I just WhatsApped it to you.
No, but now you have to go to that same file and email it to me. Can you do that? Because I'm on email. Oh, you call my high grade Carstens. I'll throw that into a session right now. I don't care. But people,
hang on.
But
there's Art Matthews at me. No!
What are you doing? Give me my email address. anyway, there's my email address. Everybody, please do email me as much as you can. Some things to notice during a live broadcast.
Can we
rewind. We can't rewind them. Wait, that is, oh my goodness. We're getting such good views and such love. Guys, thank you so much for listening to the two of us talk absolute kakalakas. Mom, if I apologize, I hope you logged off long time ago because we're smoking tacha and we said the F word twice and we talked about chicks and all that stuff. So sorry about that.
Well, I mailed it to you.
Okay. please don't read the email address out again. Here we go. Imagine that. Gary, speaking of which, how are you, sir? Jeez, will you please get Anna and I at the next legendary golfing event that you do, also from the goodness of your heart. There's so many good people out there, really. There are, and it does pain us to see them suffering and like, jeez, we've all gone through it. I think the last few days in particular, like, I've just been seeing Oaks pouring their hearts out, like devastated. And I get it. I think we all get it. I think we've been through our own versions of that. But what I will say, and this is my sentiment, it's just hang in there. You know, you're not alone, and we are all going through this cuck. I mean, look what Arno and I are having to resort to, having to entertain each other with Netflix suggestions. But you know, here we are. This is the community that we are. So yeah, bro.
Well, I tell you, it's so awesome seeing you, Art. You know, it's lovely to come and visit you at your awesome house. But it's a drive, but this is so much better, isn't it?
It's a lot easier. Bro, we're gonna do this again. I'm gonna just, if you, I think you need to tell people, are you okay? I want to know, are you writing new songs just for yourself, never mind the collab that we're gonna do? Have you been putting some things together?
Okay, so what I've got is I'm now busy finishing up this album of mine to put out, which is a compilation of all the singles I've put out, you know, for the last year or something, plus a whole bunch of new songs. And then so that's coming out, that I'm busy doing now. And then I start with an Afrikaans album, and then also I'm with Theo, we're finishing off that Swim Up Noodles album. So this year is maybe looking bleak in its sense of when it comes to shows right now, but I think it's going to pick up.
Yeah.
But I must say, music-wise, it's going to be quite a cool year because there's a lot of stuff coming out. So that's quite nice.
Yeah, bro. I mean, we've never had more time to do it. It's just about, geez, I know you've inspired me because you say you at least have a little bit of a routine that you wake up and you do something creative with. I am sure I have not done that. So this, the locking the phone away and just being in the studio has kind of evolved to this, and I've got all the knoppies are lit and there's meters going off and the mic's plugged into the drums, and I recorded some drums today and I'm working on a new song. So I think this will be a time for us to hopefully just carry on delivering the goods, but you know, for what end, who knows?
Hardcore techno. Maybe we must do hardcore techno, like old German 90s hardcore techno. And we just feed up the beat like
okay, I'm done. As long as we do it in our underpants, I'm in, bro. I'm 100%
in.
Oh, yeah. Bro, thanks for joining, my brother. Lots of love. We're going to catch up soon. I'm going to have you on again as soon as people suggest what we should call the show, and you tell me what you think, and you tell me if you want to join us to chat, come and tune us. We are humans always, and we're as screwed as everyone, but we're here to keep the geest good, hopefully. So thanks for joining us. Arno, you're a legend, brother. Cheers, boy. All right, thank you guys. That is the end of this. I don't even know what that was called. It was so, I literally came back from a walk up Chapman's Peak with my mom. Yes, with my mom. Came back, sat down, and did a sound check with Eileen. Thank you, Eileen, for being there and sorting that out. And then Simon and then Mel did a sound check. So it just evolved into who knows what it was. But I hope you enjoyed that. That's a bit of insight into the mania that we are currently experiencing, trying to get through this like by ourselves in this mental time. So we're going to do that again. Let me know what guests you'd like to see on again. I'll have all my usual buddies. I'm going to do that because I kind of dig this. This is fun. It's, you know, anything other than bad news, I guess it's a bit of a relief. But just hold in there. Be strong. It will end. You're never alone. And we'll see you again at the next stream. Thank you so much, everyone. Have a good one. Cheers.